from seeing it miles away in the sky to dreaming about it and then achieving it. This is the story of a 21-year-old Inolubele Dube from rural Gwanda in Zimbabwe. After a first flight with her parents when she was 10 years old, she became fascinated on how such big machines can stay up in the sky. And since then, she started nurturing her dream of becoming a pilot.
I just knew after the flight that this is what I want to do. I want to be the person who keeps the planes in the sky. And so in everything that I did thereafter, I was very conscious of the end goal, of the dream that I want to acquire, the subjects that I took interest in, the subjects that I put more time into, and of course the subjects that I did at A-level, that's math, physics and geography. They are the ones that cultured me for this particular career path.
Her childhood dreams are turning into reality.
The license that I'm working on right now, it's the private pilot's license, and it's the first license. It's literally the gateway to the rest of the licenses that I'll have to acquire. So, say I want to be a corporate pilot. That is actually my end goal. I want to be a corporate pilot, which is a pilot that flies business people, preferably a group of business people, so that I'm always on standby for wherever they need to go, whenever they need to go. I do not want to be an airline pilot. That's not my dream.
However, with the backing from her instructor, she says she's determined to go an extra mile to achieve her dreams.
Never let what you see limit you, because you can achieve so much more. The sky is the beginning of the limit, it's not the limit.
She's progressing quite well, to be honest. On our flight yesterday, she actually flew back by herself, unassisted by me, which is actually very good for someone at her level, being the second flight. So she's progressing very well.
Despite her towering achievements so far, Inolubele says it hasn't been an easy journey.
There are some times when obviously I was faced with obstacles and the dream seemed to falter a bit, but then my parents were always there to tell me that you can do whatever you want to do, you can be whatever you want to be. The doors that have been opened for me, I could not open them. No one else could open them, and the only person I can thank is God.
Although all about female pilots certainly does make for good headlines, the aviation industry in the world still faces significant gender disparities among pilots. From the Grand Central Airport in Johannesburg, South Africa, Bongani Siziba.